Everyone, and welcome to, or welcome back, to Ruthann's Creations. I am Ruthann. We are going to start this video by talking about crochet. Yes, it's our favorite thing, right? But some people don't know how to crochet. And what do we do about that? We're going to teach you. In this video, we'll talk about crochet, we'll talk about hooks, we'll talk about yarns, what to buy, what not to buy, different things like that, and then I'm going to show you a basic stitch. As these videos progress at the end, hopefully we will all know how to read a pattern and how to make whatever it is on our pattern that we choose, because yes, we are going to learn from the very beginning all the way up to learning how to read a pattern, and you can pick which video. Every video will be marked what it is. So this is the beginning. So, thumbnail. No, I'm goofy. So, what do we do to crochet? What is crochet? Crochet is, sorry about that, is manipulating yarn into a textiled fabric that we can use to make other things, such as manipulating this yarn into, say, granny squares, in which we will then take the granny squares, put them with other granny squares, and make an afghan, or blanket, if you prefer to call it a blanket. So, let's talk about yarns. First of all, this yarn comes from the dollar store. It used to be Dollar Tree. Now it's $1.25 store. So crocheting is not an expensive habit unless you have a yarn addiction like me, and then it can become expensive. But it doesn't. So we can go into the basic yarn that is the most abundant and the cheapest is going to be your acrylic yarn. This one happens to be from Hobby Lobby. It's a regular acrylic yarn. You'll find them in most stores that have a craft area. They will have yarn, even the dollar store. This is from the dollar store, and this is from Hobby Lobby. They have it at Walmart. It's not very expensive. So this is acrylic. It calls for, and there's all these different things. So what are these different things? This is the crochet hook size that they recommend that'll hold this yarn. And this one is a 5 millimeter. So it also has your knitting needles, which I don't knit, so I can't show you how, but this is your knitting needles. So we're going to focus on this. This is 100% acrylic. I know it's backwards. I don't know how to make it unbackwards. Is that a word? Unbackwards. Anyway, this is 100% acrylic. This is the most readily available, and it's the most economical yarn out there because it is our basic acrylic yarn. Cotton yarns, you'll see the little cotton yarns that are about this big. I wish I had one in here. I don't, but they are also inexpensive, but it's very thin. I find that the basic acrylic yarn is perfect for crocheting. So we need the yarn. We also need a hook. So I'm going to turn my video around to our workspace, and then unfortunately, or fortunately, you're only going to see my hands, but you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. So I'll be right back. Okay, so we talked about what we need, and we know we need yarn, and I'm going to do this video with acrylic yarn. I'm going to use the Hobby Lobby. I love this yarn. It is like a super saver yarn. Same with Red Heart. And that just means that the yarn is their brand of basic yarn is what it is. But it's really nice. And so is Red Heart. And Red Heart you can get right at your local Walmart. And I believe it's going to be $7.50. But think you get almost a pound of yarn. But don't quote me on that because I might be off. I don't usually buy it at Walmart. So, but that's that. And then this one is at Dollar Tree. But we're going to use this acrylic yarn. Well, what are we going to use with it? We have hooks. This particular hook is made by Boy, B-O-Y-E, and it has a gripped side. I happen to like the line of these, so I bought a whole pack at Walmart, or it's also available on Amazon. But they also sell hooks like these, and these are stainless steel. You can't bend them, break them. And these don't have, these I got at Walmart. You buy them singularly and you just buy them based on the letter and the millimeter size. And like on our yarn, it's said to use a size 5.0 millimeter hook. So that's where it says 5.5 or 6.5. That's what they suggest you use, that it's going to be a nice even flow for you. So, and they come in letters, the alphabet. This is an I or a size 9. It is 5.50 millimeters. So that's a size I. Same with the alphabet. The beginning of the alphabet, the like A, B, C, D, those are going to be your smallest needles. And they're going to go all the way up. So I usually stick between the 3.5, 2.5 once in a while. This is my 2.0 millimeter hook. I use this for a lot of thinner yarns, but as you can see, it's very small. We're not going to use that today. For this video, I am going to use my eye hook, which is a 5.25 millimeter hook. And it comes with the, I'm using the rubber one from Boy, B-O-Y-E, and it also comes in this one, which is weird because this I says 5.5, this I says 5.25. Well, that's a very bad example. Oh, so we're going to use an I hook. Check out the different hooks because it's the hook size. It's the depth of the size. So if I want to use something smaller, do you see the difference? I hope I'm holding that correctly in the camera. You see the difference in the hook size? So the depth is going to be how far laid back the hook is. Yes, it does look bigger, but also this depth is a little bit bigger. So for this purpose, I am going to use this. I'm going to use my 5.25 according to my Boy hook. Now, mostly all yarns come with a pattern inside, and don't worry, you can save them if you like the pattern on the outside, because we're going to be able to learn patterns at the end of this series. So right now, I've taken it out. We're going to make, this is Khaleesi's chain. She started to learn how to crochet. So this is her chain. I'm just going to cut that off. So all we need is the hook, the yarn, and a pair of scissors. Very easy. I believe hooks are under $3. Any pair of scissors, even kid scissors, will work. And your yarn is under 10. So right now, if we had scissors on hand, any old scissors, even the meat scissors from our kitchen, we are at about $11, $10, depending on tax in your state. We're around $10, $11, and we can begin a project. You can usually get a nice size scarf out of one thing of yarn. So this is how we're going to work it. Every pattern, no matter what it is, starts with a chain. We need our basic base to continue to work off of. And as we make other stitches, we will be making a sample size of approximately 5x5 to 6x6, enough to see the stitches. And that'll give us a chance to practice every stitch. At the end of learning all of our stitches, we can make something with those stitches that we've learned in the future. So to begin with, we must make a knot. Just like you're tying a shoe. I'm tied my shoe, but I want another tie the same way, like I'm tying a shoe, one on top of the other. I'm sorry if my nails are distracting. one on top of the other. So see, I just have two and pull it shut, but I'm not going to pull it tight. See, that's what I have. All it is the beginning of a shoelace tie and then another beginning of a shoelace tie. And I'm going to slide it off my finger. So this is not tight. And I can pull it and I can pull on it. And if you see, I'm not pulling the tail, I'm pulling the other side, and it makes it shorter. Don't close it because we are going to insert our hook in there. And then we can pull it towards our hook, but we don't want it tight. And I'm sorry if you can hear the TV or the dogs barking. We have the football game on and the roofers are here and my dogs go nuts. So this is nice and loose. Nice and loose because we want to work with it. Now, all we want to do is first you have to figure out how you want to hold your hook. This is how I hook it. This might not be the same as somebody else. There are many styles to hold your yarn. It's going to be whatever you feel comfortable doing to get what you're getting, like to get where you want to be. So the way I show you might not be the way you feel most comfortable holding the needle in the yarn, and that is fine because as you progress, you'll find a different way to hold it. This is how I do it. So all we're going to do is we want to wrap. This is my yarn coming off of my skein. We want to wrap it around so that we have the, this is from my skein and this was on the hook. See, this is my base. All we're going to do is pull that new one through the skein through over so that we have a stitch. And I don't think I explained that right. So we're just going to wrap around the top. So we want to be able to pull it. See, all I did was wrap it around and I'm going to pull that top one under that bottom one. So I'm hooking it through. So I'm going to wrap it around. So now I've hooked that yarn and this is the one that's on the hook. I want to make this new one under here. So my hook is going to hold that and I'm just going to slide it under. That's it. And now as you see, we've chained three times. So you might not see that, but we have one, two, three chains. So we've done that three times. We're going to keep repeating this until your chain is nice and even. So if you notice on Khaleesi's, she's done pretty well. And see how there's a twist? She's just been stitching and twisting her yarn all around. And that's what makes a twist in here. She also didn't pull her needle tighter or hold it consistently. So she has bigger spots and little spots. I taught my daughter how to crochet. And I can tell you, she was about the same age that it took a while and she eventually did not like me because I would always undo these. But if we make something like this, it might not turn out the best and we might think, well, what did we do wrong? Usually what we do wrong always starts in the beginning because if our base is wrong, the rest of it will be wrong. So we want to make sure that's nice and even. So we want to be able to chain. So we're going to keep it nice and close, but not tight against our needle. And all we have to do is push up our stitches with our thumb. Push it up. That's it. So now we're going to wrap it around. And I'm going to pull that top one through the bottom. And I'm always holding this. No matter how long this chain gets, I'm always going to be holding because you want to be able you want to be like, how can I put this? You want to be in charge. You want to be telling the stitches to stay even. And as long as you're holding that top one or the top couple, these next ones are going to stay right in line. So I'm pulling it over and I'm pulling through. I'm hooking the yarn and I'm pulling it through. I'm wrapping it around and hooking it. Now, if I didn't hold this and this just went amok and I twisted it, it's going to look funny. See, these are all in row because I'm holding it. I'm the one in charge. And we're pulling the bottom one, pulling it through the bottom one. So I've hooked it. I'm in charge of this. And I'm pulling it through. I'm going to wrap it around and I'm going to pull it through. Wrap it around and pull it through. It doesn't matter if it twists down here because we've been in charge up here and this is where the action is. So if we keep our stitches in line up here, like when they're babies and they're down here being teenagers, who cares if they run amok? Because our top ones we know are nice. So we're going to wrap it around and we're going to pull it through. Wrap it around and pull it through. And we're going to do this for a while because this is our base of our first stitch. So this is a chain and we want to make it pretty long. And I'm going to make this say about 8 inches. So we're going to hold these babies. I'm going to hold this and we're going to wrap it around and pull that top one under. That's all we're doing. And this is just how I hold it to get this chain going. You can hold it whatever way you want. Sorry, working on this table is new to me and I have the camera up next to me and I'm trying to stay in. Okay, so I have this chain. Now what do we do, Ruth? How are we going to make this into anything? Well, not only is this a chain, it is common, and you'll see it in all patterns, and we'll see it in the future. This is a chain, and its abbreviation is CH, so chain. Now we're going to make a single crochet. Single crochet is SC, and we'll learn those abbreviations in the future. How do we do that? So we're going to hold our yarn and we have our crochet and these are our chains. See the little circles sticking up in each one or they make a V or a teardrop. That's a stitch. That's a stitch. That's a stitch. So we're going to skip this first one on the hook because if we go into that with our hook, it's going to come undone because we just pulled it through. So we're going to skip that one. And we're going to go into this next hump. There's a little hump there. See, here's my V. One each of the V. And we're going to go under that V. And this is where if we kept it nice and good, we can do it. Whoops, and I went through the wrong V. So we're going to go through that V. And yes, it might be a little tight. So now I'm through the V. And I'm going to hook that yarn. Just like I did in the chain, and I'm going to pull it through, and we're going to have two loops, two, on the hook. What are we going to do? We're going to wrap it around again, and instead of pulling the one through, we're going to pull through both. And now we've got something that looks like this, and you might think, oh my gosh, I did it wrong, but you didn't. We're going to go back to our chain. So we did this first one, and now we're going to go to the next one, which is right there. See, there's our next V. I just went into that one, and now I'm going into that one. So I'm going to go in the top, and if we kept it nice and loose, it should be easy. This first layer isn't always easy. See, I'm going in the V. Maybe I am, maybe I'm not. No, I'm really going in that V. I'm looking at the camera and I shouldn't do that. So I've gone in this first one. I'm trying to go in the second one. See, I have two. I'm in the hole. I'm going to wrap it around. I'm going to pull that out of the hole. And now I have two. I'm going to wrap it around and I'm going to pull through both. Now look at, we've made two stitches. I know it doesn't look like that, but it will. I promise. So now this is my next hole. It is my next chain. So I'm going to go through there and I'm gonna pull one out. Ta-da! We have two. We're gonna wrap it around and we're gonna pull that new yarn through underneath those two. So now we have three stitches. I know it still doesn't look it, but it does. Now you're probably asking, how many will we have at the end? Because Ruth Ann, you did not count these. I did not count these because this is the first time we're trying it. And I can say I have 20 on a chain and have 20 at the end, but we're just learning and we might skip some or we might do two and one, and that is okay. It's not how many we do in the beginning, it's how many we do, period. So we want to get to this line, but we're not going to be tied down to a number because in the beginning I skip some chains, and in the beginning I've put two in one and it didn't matter because you know what? I made it to the end. And that's what matters. So we're going to keep going to the end. So here's our next stitch. It's right there. You might not see it, but it's there. There's our V right there. So I'm going to, and it's going to be tight on this first one, I know. I'm going to slip it through and I'm going to pull one out. And I'm going to have two. I'm going to hook the new one out of this from the skein. I'm going to wrap it around and I'm going to pull it underneath these two. And look at the finish ones. As you can see, the V's are now on top. Here, they're on the string, but here you can really see them. One, two, three, and we have one on our hook. We've done four stitches. You're doing great. So now we're going to go down to our chain, and with our chain, there's a bump on top and there's a bump on the bottom because these are looped through each other. So we're going to keep it not tight, but remember, we're in charge. Now, see, this is my next one right there. So I'm going to put it through. See how I did that? I put it through and I hooked this new yarn and I'm pulling it through the hole and I have two on my hook. I'm going to hook that new yarn again and I'm going to pull it right through those other two. That is a single crochet. I'm in the next one. I'm going in the hoop. And I'm wrapping around the new one and I'm pulling it out. And I have two on. I'm going to hook it again and I'm going to pull through those two. That's all there is. We're going to do that all the way down to the end. So, however many you made, we're going to the end. So, I'm going to do it with you in real time. So you can watch me going through and wrapping it around. That's it. There's my next one. I hope you can see it. You'll be able to see it on yours. If you don't see it and you see that next one, go for it. Pulling it through, I have two wrapping around. I'm pulling my new one through. That is a single crochet. You're doing great, by the way. Going to the next one, putting it through. And I have another one. As you get going, you'll see that you can do this. And that was easy. But it's just like anything. If we learn in the beginning, it's always difficult. It's always hard to learn something. We're holding a crochet hook and yarn, and we're trying to manipulate the two together. That is not common for our arm or for our hands. It's very unfamiliar. It's very foreign on how to do this. Just like riding a bike was very foreign in the beginning. If you've rode a bike, once you learn it, it's very hard to forget. So we're going in that next bump. We're pulling out a thread. We have two threads. We're going to wrap it around and we're going to pull it through. There's our next V. You don't see that V, but you see that one? Go in that one. Here, I'll go in that one with you. I'm going to skip one. I'll show you what it looks like if we happen to skip one. Look at that. We happened to skip one. Do you see a difference? Just a little hole. We're going to cover that up in the next row. Doesn't matter. And you know, everything you do with yarn is handmade. Do you know, they call it when you quilt and you make a mistake. In the Amish tradition, there's always a mistake, and they call it the Amish mistake. Why do they do that? Because they believe that nobody is perfect except God. So no handmade item shall come out perfect. So do I leave an Amish mistake in my quilting? Well, my quiltings are far from perfect, so yes. So now look it. I just have a little bit left of our chain. It's nice and straight. Now we want to go keep going. Doesn't matter that this gets crooked and gets whiny. When we're working with it, it'll be straight. Go in the next one. Pull it through. We have two. Wrap it around and pull it through. Go to our next little hump. You don't see the little humps? Let me try again to show you the little humps. They look like little V's. There's one. You can see the bottoms of them really good. But wherever there's a bottom, there's a top. And this is the middle. So we're going to go on the top. There's one. There's one. This one is our next one. So we want to go in those. We're just going to put it through. Hook a new one out. We have two on our hook. Wrap it around and pull it through. And in the next one. Only the beginning chain is what seems different because we have to make a base for our yarn to live on, for our project to live on. So, whoops. See, I almost screwed up. And you can use that hook to your advantage. Oh, I'm going in here. Pulling through one out. I have two on my hook and I'm going to pull it through. There's my next one. Gonna put it in. If your chains are very hard to get through, it is because when you did your chain, your tension or how you hold your thread coming out and how tight you're holding it, that just means your tension is too tight. So you want to loosen up on the skeined yarn, not on the tail or the project, but how tight this is. This should always be able to slide. If it doesn't go very well, or you can hear it crunching up against your hook, then your tension is a little bit tight and you want to loosen up just a little because we're not in here to hurt ourselves or to make ourselves frustrated. This is something that we're going to do to relax us, to make things, to make gifts. Look at that. That doesn't even want to go through there. Well, I'll be a son of a gunion. I'm going to skip it. See that? We just skipped another one. And you know what? I'm not fretting. Now we're at the end. Oh my gosh, what are we going to do? We're at the end. That's what your last stitch is going to look like. There's the top. So we're going to go in there. And it's a bigger hole. I know. That's all right. And pull it through just like we did another one. All the others. And this is what the end of our chain looks like now. Look at all those stitches. So some of mine are different. See, that one sticks up a little bit, but that's all right. It's the same as all the others. Look at that. And you can't really tell where we skipped. Well, you can, but you're not going to see it in a minute. So now we're at the end of our row. What are we going to do? We are going to chain one. Do you remember how to chain? That's grabbing the yarn and pulling it through. One chain. I don't know how many we did here. We probably did about 20. So we chain one. And now guess what? We're going to go back. We're going to turn it around. And see how those single crochets made a V on top? They also made a hole. So now we are going to go back and see how that there's a hole there. We're going to go through that hole. And if you look at the top of your work, there's two stitches. That's the top of the single
crochet we just made in the last group. So we're going to push it through that hole, we're going to hook it, and we're going to pull it through. We have two on each. Wrap it around and pull through two. You see that? This is our next hole. Put it through, pull out the yarn, wrap it around, and pull through two. This is what it looks like from the top. It's the full V. We put our hook through the hole. There's still the V. We're going to wrap it around, pull it through. We have two. We're going to wrap it around and pull it through. We're going to put it in the next hole. And this is why I like the bigger needles, because it leaves a bigger hole. So we're going to put it through the hole, pull it through. We have two on our hook. We're going to wrap it around and pull it through. And we are going to continue doing this. I'll do it with you. Put it through the hole, wrap it around. We have two. Put it through the hole, pull it through. We have two. It's just like the chain, only now, boy, we have a hole. That's like exciting, because now we have, you know, we don't have to try to put it in somewhere, because what we've created on the row below is allowing us to see where we are going. So we are putting it through the hole. Do you see that hole? See how that made a nice hole there for us? There's one. We're putting it through the hole. We're wrapping it around. We're hooking it through. We have two on the hook. We're going to wrap it around and pull it through. And we're going to keep doing that. I'm going to do it with you to the end. We're going to put it through, pull it out, wrap it around, and pull it through. We're going to put it in, pull it out. We're going to do this all the way to the end. Together. I'm going to put it through our next hole. I hope everyone can see this good. We're going to put it through the hole. Oops, I put it through the wrong hole because I was looking at my camera. I'm going to put it through the hole. See, there's a V on top. And pull it out. See how easy it's going? It'll go easy for you. Trust me. You have to figure out how you want to hold the needle and how you want to hold this. This is going to be by your choice. Some people hold it like this, like a pencil. I can't do that. This is how I hold it. I taught myself to crochet long before there was ever YouTube videos. No one in my family crocheted. No one in my family ever did anything creative. My mother worked all the time and my father was an engineer. Nobody did anything. Okay, so I'm right before the end. Now I'm at the end. See that last one? I'm gonna. There's a hole. It's a little hole, but it's there. I'm gonna go in that one. I'm gonna pull it out, and I'm gonna crochet. Single crochet. Now look at what we've done. Look at what we've completed together. Look at that. You're crocheting. You're doing awesome. I'm at the end of my square. Now what? What do we do? We're at the end of the row. We're going to chain one. By chaining one, we're not going to undo this when we go back in it. We're going to turn it. We're going to go right back in that first hole. And look at those holes for us. Look at that. Now look at how your end looks. Incredible. So with this, you can continue and make it as tall as you want. Make your chain, say, as wide as you might want a scarf. Or make your chain about a square. You know, you make it as high as wide as it is wide. Make it as high as wide. You know, see these holes? We're going to continue in all of these holes. We're just going to keep going. So let me get to the end with you. I only crochet this fast because I have 40 years of experience. Yep, I'm that old. I know I don't look it. I get told that a lot, but oh well. Oh yeah. Maybe when I'm 90, I won't look 90. I can assure you my body is falling apart like a regular person my age. So we're going to keep going in the hole. See, we're going to go in the hole. There's a V on top. Go in the hole, wrap it around, pull it through. Wrap it around, pull it through both. We're going to continue that. It doesn't matter that our project is curling up underneath us. That doesn't matter. Remember, we're holding the babies. These are the teenagers, and they can run amok because the babies that we're in charge of, they're doing the right thing. We're in the last stitch. We're in that last one. See the hole? We're going to go in that hole, and we're going to do a stitch. So we're at the end. So what do we have to do? Now, if we turn this and we went directly in that hole, we'll undo that. So we have to put a chain. Do you remember what a chain is? We did it down here. We wrap it around and pull it through. See? Let me do it again because you might have been off camera. Let me put it back in there. We're going to wrap it around and we're going to pull it through. See? Let me do it again. We're at the end. We're going to wrap it around and we're going to pull it through without losing it. Now, Ruth, what happens if I drop my hook or it comes undone? Oh, here I am and it looks like this now. I don't know where I'm at. I can see that my yarn is here, but you know what? Don't be afraid to pull it out until you have this one. Doesn't matter about this one. This one's attached to the skein. Here is our hoop for this is where we were. This is where we're going. So we can continue on. Nice and loose. We're back to that end one. I'm going to put it through that hole. Pull it through. Pull it through two. And I'm going to chain one. And I'm going to turn my kids around. And look at that nice big hole right there waiting for me. Going right in it. Shadaisy, look at that. I can't believe y'all are this far. Congratulations. Now, I know that I did this in a matter of, like, I think my video. And when you stop. Now, I've done this far, Ruth Ann, but I want to get up and go make dinner. I've got to get up and go to work. What do I do? How do I save my space? Well, I could leave it like this, but if you have dogs like me, this will never last. All you do is pull your yarn up, make a nice big loop, and then, now I made a big loop, right? That'll hold, this will hold. So now I'm back. Ruth, what do? Well, I take my hook and I put it in, and I grab my skein yarn, and I just pull on it, and it pulls back to where I was, and pull it to your tightness that you want, and you can continue on. Now, keep making this. Make it as long as you want. This can be a scarf, but look at those nice stitches you did in the beginning. Look at your ends. Remember, we are doing a single crochet. This is a single crochet. This is the first stitch. We've done two stitches. We've done the chain, and we've done a single crochet. You have done two stitches. That is something to be proud of. And it might curl. That's okay. That's fine. If it curls, it's just because you skipped some in here in the chain, and that's okay. It'll work itself out. And if it doesn't matter because it's yours. This is what you've created, and that's what it's going to look like. Look at your end. Nice. If your end starts to go inward, it's just because we've skipped that chain one. So continue on because this is your basis for everything. Everything is going to start with a chain. Everything might not start with a single crochet, and we'll find that out when we get to pattern making. But look at that. Look at, this is what your ends look like. Excuse me. This is it. Continue this on. If you continue this and use this whole skein, boy, you're going to have the most beautiful scarf. Or if you don't think it's wide enough, that's fine too. You can make a scarf for a kid. You don't even have to make a scarf. You can take it apart and practice your chains, just as Khaleesi is. Practice the chains. It doesn't matter if your chain is the whole length of the skein, that'll be an afghan. However wide you make this will be the width of your project. Or it'll be the total length. If you continue on and make this wide enough so you can wrap it around and it'll go on ahead, you can make a hat. So chain and single crochet. That's what you've accomplished.
I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. I hope that you're able to tackle the single crochet and the chain. This is what you've made today if you followed along and were able to do it. And if you can't do it today, continue to practice, because every day you practice is a step towards completing. Continue this on and make it as tall as you want. But this is your chain and this is your single crochet. And I have faith that everyone can do this. Walk back, rewind, and chain with me again. Don't be discouraged. It's something new. Holding a crochet hook in your hand and yarn and trying to work the two is very foreign to us all if we have not done it. You just can't walk in and pick something up and say, oh, well, this feels good in my hand. It doesn't. It doesn't. I mean, let's be honest. If we don't know how to do it, it is a foreign object in our hand, and we have to learn how to hold it and manipulate correctly. And if we can't do that, then we have to work at it. And that's okay. It's okay. So in this video, it is chain and single crochet. Join me for our next video as we do chain and the very next higher stitch, which would be a half double. That video is to come. So pick your chain. Again, I used an eye hook by Boy, B-O-Y-E. I believe it came from a Walmart pack. It comes in many different, they come all together in one pack. I might have gotten it on Amazon. It's been a long time. Or if you go to the Dollar Tree, or I don't think Family Dollar carries it, but Dollar Tree and Walmart, they carry stainless steel if that feels better on your hand. I used a 5.25 hook. According to Boy, it is an eye hook. And I like it because it's got the rubber and it'll turn around and stuff. But I like it because it's a rubber. You can buy rubber handles on Amazon, I think, to put your real ones in. But, you know, to put the stainless steel ones in. But I learned on stainless steel. I was glad when this came out. I'm not gonna lie. Chain and single crochet. I used an eye 5.25 hook. And I used I Love This Yarn at Hobby Lobby. This is 100% acrylic. It's also Red Heart. You can also get it at the dollar store. This is 4-weight yarn, basic acrylic yarn. It's what I used. It handles well over the hook, and it should be easy for anyone to pick up. I would advise that you not start with blanket yarn, big soft yarns, because those are more, even the Karen soft, it's going to be very slippery to you, slick. The acrylic yarn will handle best on your hook. And it's what I recommend. Let's see. There is like this, sorry, my sewing room is a mess. I have this little tiny, this is glow in the dark. It's very small. It's by Lion Brand. And this is like a, I don't even know. Ew, it's a 4-weight, but it's very small. Hold the yarns. When you go to the store, there's no law that says you can't touch all the yarn. Touch it all. See what might fit best. Bring your crochet hook with you. Or, you know, if you're going to buy a crochet hook, open it up. See what hook's good. I find that the eye hook with a Worsen weight is the easiest. It's what I taught my daughter with. It's what I'm teaching Khaleesi with. Eye hook and Worsen weight. Acrylic 4-weight. So enjoy. If you did and make anything, please comment below and add a picture. I would love to see it. Ask me any questions you want. Today's video was single crochet, which is up here, and our chain, which is the starting to all projects. So please continue. Leave a comment below, like, comment, share me, and subscribe. It's free. If you hit the bell, it tells you when I've made another video. So thank you for joining me. I do appreciate each and every one of you. And stay tuned. If you hit the bell, you'll know when the next basic series stitch comes out. Until then, have a great day, and thanks for stopping by. Bye-bye.